this license to you. ULOC and Total and CDOC, we are in it together.
On 24th of January this year, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Dr. Ruth Nankabira Saint-Amu, handed over an operation license to the Managing Director of ECOP, Martin Tiffen. The President of Uganda, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, revealed that oil is not a problem to the country, as it has been said by some environmental activists.
Oil is not a problem at all, because, first of all, the carbon dioxide, which comes from these fossil fuels, is not necessarily a problem if it is handled well.
The managing director for ECOP Company Limited, Martin Tiffen, while speaking during the commissioning of the acquisition of the land, said this signals the start of the construction of the project, since 68% out of 3,648 project affected persons were compensated in Uganda and 91% in Tanzania.
So today we're here to mark the completion of ECOP's first land acquisition in Uganda. So that's the 47 acres around us here. The pipeline itself, you know, is starting in Kabale. It will come past Hoima. It will cross under the road about 1 kilometer, 1.5 kilometers north of here. Basically go down to Mubende and then down to the border, Mutakula. So all together, that's 298 kilometers in Uganda.
Tiffen says the acquired land will be transferred to Uganda Land Commission and leased to ECOP Company Limited to develop the project itself as per the host government's agreement.
The process of constructing 174 houses, which we call replacement houses, along the 300 kilometers of pipeline in Uganda. And today we've signed with 81% of there's a total of 3,648 PAPs. 81% we signed the compensation agreements as we spoke now, and 69% have also received their compensations in their bank accounts.
According to Hani Malinga, the Director of Petroleum in the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development, this is part of the commercialization journey where 50% of the crude will be for export and 50% refined locally.
The project is part of the commercialization plan. We have crude to the refinery, and we have crude to the pipeline, which later goes for export. The selection of this route took time. It was not something which government or government decided, let us use this route through Tanzania.
Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom Prime Minister Andrew Byakutaga says oil discovery has enabled the region to witness tremendous development.
For a long time, Bunyoro region has been underdeveloped. We had poor roads, markets, education and health facilities, among others. Our literacy levels and other socioeconomic development indicators have been low for a very long time. It is exciting to see that a lot of transformation is happening in this region following the discovery of oil and gas resources.
The Premier further revealed that he has been receiving complaints from companies in Bunyoro, saying they have been sidelined. He has asked oil companies to address the issue.
Production activities have already commenced. I have also regularly received complaints from registered companies in Bunyoro who claim that they are sidelined in oil business opportunities. Petroleum Authority of Uganda, ECOP, and oil companies, we need to sit and address these concerns.
Of the 47 acres of land, 32% of the project affected persons have been fully compensated, and they're also in the process of constructing 174 replacement houses to the people to be affected by the construction of the pipeline. Uganda has 6.9 billion confirmed barrels of oil since 2006 and 1.4 billion barrels considered recoverable. The project includes a 60,000 barrels per day oil refinery, which will pick crude from two central processing facilities at Kingfisher and Tilenga in Chikube and Bulisa districts. The labor camps for the crude oil export pipeline, which will transport crude from Hoima district in Uganda to Tanga Port in Tanzania, shall be located in Hoima, Mubende, Rakai, and Kakumiro. Report compiled by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.